Vanakkam. I'm Vayoni Dimel. This is Boston Lanka News, so bringing you news, views, and entertainment from Boston and USA.
Was just a dream, is now reality.
DeLon, the Sri Lankan origin international recording artist who resides in Los Angeles, is igniting a musical revolution through his feel-good music movement. With the power of his pen and the magic of the microphone, DeLon is on a mission to promote unity and a common purpose through feel-good music.
Now the whole world has stopped, and if you were all I got,
DeLon joins with us from his studio in LA. DeLon, in your website it says that you are on a mission to promote unity and common purpose through feel-good music. Could you elaborate on that?
Sure. Well, the feel-good music movement I started in 2009, and it was really born out of, you know, post Sri Lanka's war, and it was born out of there because I felt it was really important that we unite ourselves as a country, and that there was an artist who at one point, you know, had his opinion at this point, just wants people to have a good time and be together. You know, I completely am different in the way I feel about, you know, what's going on in Sri Lanka. I think it's important that we're all trying to help each other become better and unite the country instead of divide the country through war or through people who are heavily opinionated and not willing to see other people's opinions. And also, you know, at the end of the day, I'm different in the sense that I've grown up a little bit and I feel like we should have fun. You know, music is about fun. Music is about having a good time and having that 3.5 minutes, 4 minutes of escape from the regular crazy lives that we all live every day.
And baby girl, I don't speak your language, but your body dangerous and hers too. What you wanna do? Stick to me like a tattoo to both of you. I'll raise a toast for you. Champagne glass and later on I'ma wax that ass. And if she good, let her in before we finish the test. Cause I know she know where the business is at. My business is cash and I'm spending it fast. Rocks and rings, yeah, that's a CR thing. And I don't spend on dimes, that's a cheapy thing. And if y'all know the line, y'all know we OG, man.
You're a Sri Lankan origin international recording artist who has hit international billboards. Could you share with us briefly your journey and how you began your career?
Yeah, actually, I was born in Los Angeles, believe it or not. The journey started when I was growing up in Pasadena, California. And I was at a school where they didn't play a lot of hip-hop music. That was the music I kind of grew up on as a kid. And when I moved schools, they didn't play a lot of that music. And I asked my brother, hey, maybe we should start a DJ company and, you know, fill that void of not playing that type of music. And my brother, who was 5 years older than me at the time, said, sure. And so we did that. And I was 12 when I started playing DJing at high schools and stuff like that in middle schools. And I fell in love with music and it kind of never changed. And my dad, obviously, he wanted me to be a doctor like every other Sri Lankan dad. And he definitely pushed me down that direction. And I did study finance and real estate in college, but I could never get away from the music. So the passion started at 12 and it remains now.
And now, DeLon, you started your career in 2005 with the release of your first album, Connection. Then you released your next album, Unstoppable. And with that, you have become an unstoppable star. Tell us about Unstoppable and how you feel hitting Billboard charts big time, even number one in some international markets.
Yeah, you know, I have to credit a lot of people, Running Vu being one of them, because Running Vu and I did a song called Nasty Girls that hit number one in Sri Lanka and hit really high on the international charts as well. Iraj was involved in my first album, so through Iraj being involved, not in the first album itself, but just helping me promote the first album, in the second album when I broke, it was crazy because in the United States, I never thought anything like that would actually happen, even though I released in the United States first. So it just felt really good. And then in Sri Lanka, I had four number one hits in a row. And then I got to win Best Rap Performance at Derna Music Awards in 2007, which is when I dropped the album. And everything snowballed. And I remember thinking about the song. I don't know if you remember the song, Vioni. It's called Video Killed the Radio Star. Well, that song is true, because the moment a music video came out with my face on it, I went from being relatively unknown but people knowing my voice to walking around Sri Lanka and people going, oh, that's DeLon, that's DeLon, that's DeLon, that's the rapper, that's this guy. Every country I go to at this point, you know, when people recognize me, they recognize me, and it's a great feeling. I love it. It's a great feeling. And I don't know if you know this, but I have a huge tattoo on my back that says Ceylon, C-E-Y-L-O-N, our country. So people know immediately where I'm from.
We gonna be there tomorrow, you feel me? And enjoy the journey, cause it's gonna be something you won't forget, believe me. We touch down in the evening, then the Raj pick us up, now we drinking. Out the tramps and the D's and the candy, will I take your panties, please? I know you like this treatment, get your head sprung, then get done for the weekend. Yeah, we ride, I'll be back. Tell that Maldivian girl to sing the track.
You have been touring from South Asia to Europe. What was the reaction or response from those audiences? Is there any message that you want to bring to your audiences?
Yeah, well, I mean, I've been received very well. I mean, I think people are happy to just hear good music and hear talent that they like. At the end of the day, I think it's not really about where you're from anymore. It's about what you're doing. And every time that I got out on stage everywhere around the world so far, it's been really fun. And some people have no idea who I am, right? So I get on stage and it's an exercise in winning over a crowd. And when you do that and the crowd loves you, it's really fun. And I guess the message is just make good music. It doesn't matter where you're from or what you're doing in the past. It matters what you're doing now and how good your music is and how people receive it. And, you know, even with the new song, it's the same thing. It doesn't matter that I'm Sri Lankan. It doesn't matter where I was born. It doesn't matter what language I speak. It matters they like the song.
You gon' miss me if I ever lead a game. I'm going out like Bugsy, yeah. So speak it. Every day of the week is a part of my weekend. This is the life that we be in. 3 in the morning getting money while your haters still sleeping. Pot, basketball teams and cars for toys. Used to work at Whole Foods, J. Crew. My story's much longer than yours. You frankly bore me. Never in the sun, always where the storm be. Young D used to stretch green like Gumpy. Now I'm presidential, got a country that fund me. Yeah.
DeLon, you're also being called as a political activist. You had a very open difference of opinion with MIA about LTTE, the Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam, a few years ago. Tell us about your activism.
Me and my family started a nonprofit called Sri Lanka Foundation, and we worked a lot with helping in the tsunami at that time, and just helping Sri Lankans gain recognition here in America, and, you know, being a hub for Sri Lankans. The activism the activism was born out of the things that I'd seen. I think everybody from both sides of this war have seen things that make them hate the other side. And at this point in my life, I think that we need to wash that, both sides, including myself. And, you know, my expressed statement I made versus MIA and LTTE was very strong at the time. And at this point, I don't feel the same way. You may have fooled Jude Law and Julia Robinson, the whole of America. Nah, but you ain't fooled me. Seen the tiger on your shirt in your first CD. That's right. And nah, you ain't fooled the FBI either, United Nations. Why you think you could come back here? Yeah, and for those who don't know the truth, you could Google the LTTE group. Yeah, so you know what the tiger represents. The death of the innocent. I feel like I can understand where people can, where hate can be born. I can understand it because I too had a furious amount of anger about that situation. And as time went on and I went to go see the war myself, you know, I noticed that both sides have a reason to be angry, but at this time that makes both sides wrong, which means that both sides have a reason to let go, right? No one side is right all the time. And my activism at the time was one-sided. And then after that, I put out a song where Michael Jackson, I did a remix of Michael Jackson, Man in the Mirror, where I said, hey, listen, let's just stop all the fighting and let's figure out how to handle this problem together as a group. Your side, my side, your side. There's no more sides. We're all one group. So I think at this point, I've completely changed my opinion on how I feel about it. And I think, especially for me, there's no hatred. I know there's a lot of people out there that that are on the LTT side per se that really, really don't like me. And I want to tell them, listen, I'm sorry for making you guys so angry. You know, at the time I was there, I'm not there anymore. And I hope you guys can understand and see it in yourselves to forgive that, because at the end of the day, we're all together and we need to figure out how to work together. And there's only love on my side for both sides.
Now let's talk about your latest album, Pretty Girl. It's climbing Billboard charts as we speak. What is so unique about this song? Why you think it has become a hit internationally?
I think because pretty girls are awesome. And I think because at the end of the day, you know, men and women, we're the only two sexes on earth. There's only men and there's only women. That's it. There's nothing else. We're all humans. Either we're men or we're women. And that's the common denominator of life. It's a common denominator of how we survive is through love or through, through, you know, having children, right? So when I say something like, look at all the pretty girls, even the pretty girls go, yes, I'm a pretty girl. Look at me. Or the girls go, yeah, this is an awesome thing. Or the guys go, I know, I do it every day. It's just a relatable concept and people have fun. And, you know, I remember when I was living in West Hollywood, I'd come out of my apartment and I'd stand on the curb and I'd just be blown away by the amount of beautiful women there were in that city. And I remember going to the studio and I was like, man, I need to make a song about all the pretty girls in the world. Guys could do it all day. Just stare at women's pictures and, you know, Facebook, whatever app you decide to use. It's just it's a great concept. You know, I love women, obviously. It goes to show in the song, and I think people like it. They understand it. It makes sense to them. Every time someone goes at a bar, girls looking for guys are looking for girls. It's a natural common denominator of life. I think that's probably the reason. Other than the fact that the hook is really catchy and, you know, people like melodies. I think that's probably another great thing. It's not just a rap song. It's like an R&B-ish rap song. So.
Street in a three-wheel buggy trying to get something to eat. Is funny out here, 100 rupees, lot of money, 30 rupees for Cini Pine. Man, I'm hungry, get bowl two for my buddy, two to fill my belly. That's $1.20 added up in American money. Now you see how we live, it ain't lovely, but we still happy. Play cricket at the school with Pappy.
This is your boy DeLon. You can check me out on Twitter at DeLon Music. You can always check me out on Facebook, facebook.com/DeLon Music, and my website, DeLonMusic.com. We're out here getting into the United States. I hope you guys support. Hit me up anytime. You know where to find me. Peace.
That concludes our news edition. We meet you again with another news edition of News, Views, and Entertainment from Boston and USA. Till then, goodbye.